We're here today at the Scioto Audubon Metro Park to celebrate the 25th anniversary of Ohio's Voluntary Action Program. The Voluntary Action Program was created to give local governments or property owners a way to investigate possible contamination, clean it up if necessary, and receive a legal release from the state of Ohio that no more cleanup is needed. To date, more than 13,500 acres of contaminated land on 615 sites over 69 counties have been cleaned up through the Voluntary Action Program, including the beautiful park we're in today. Here are a few highlights from the Voluntary Action Program's 25 years.
Since the 1870s, the Whittier Peninsula in Columbus, Ohio, was formerly home to many industrial services and the City of Columbus impound lot. Polluted by vehicle fluids and unlicensed illegal dumping, the City of Columbus cleaned the site from 2008 throughout 2015. After the massive cleanup effort, the location became the Scioto Audubon Metro Park. The 120-acre park boasts restored wetlands, biking and walking trails, riverside access, a rock climbing wall, and the Grange Audubon Insurance Nature Center. Annually, over 300,000 visitors enjoy the park's beauty, facilities, and resources. The Toledo Jeep Assembly Plant in Toledo, Ohio, was home to a century-old automotive manufacturing facility that closed its doors in 2006. In 2010, the Toledo-Lucas County Port Authority purchased the 111-acre site to redevelop a sustainable, industrial, innovative business area named Overland Industrial Park. The Port Authority has invested approximately $14 million to redevelop the site, attracting commercial businesses such as the Dana Holding Corporation and Detroit Mechanical Systems. The addition of these facilities has the potential to add over 400 jobs by the year 2020. The Empire Steel property in New Boston, Ohio, was a steel mill and slag plant for over 100 years. The mill permanently shut down in 1980, but the underground gas transmission line was in operation until the coke plant closed in 2002. Between 1996 and 2013, pollutants throughout roughly 116 acres were cleaned up. The remediation consisted of excavating contaminated soil and limiting the land to commercial or industrial use. Currently, a portion of the property is used as a steel distributor, while the remainder holds restaurant and retail stores, including a Walmart. For over 100 years, the East Bank of the Flats was one of Cleveland's oldest industrial areas. In the 1980s, the area mostly served as parking lots for degraded bars and nightclubs, and after a tremendous downturn from unsafe conditions, many establishments began closing. In the early 2000s, the area was almost completely abandoned when developers, in conjunction with the City of Cleveland and Cuyahoga County, began purchasing properties, demolishing abandoned structures, and cleaning up various pollutants from historical operations. Today, the Flats is a thriving symbol of public and private investments, healthy waterways, historic preservation, upscale residences, dining, nightlife, and entertainment. The American Can Building in Cincinnati, Ohio, was built in 1921 and primarily included the manufacturing of can-making machinery, then mixed industrial and commercial use. In 2006, all industrial and commercial activity ceased after a local redevelopment company purchased the property. After years of cleanup, the historical building was renovated and reopened its doors in 2011. The building was converted into loft apartments and mixed commercial use, including green spaces, a cafe, and amenities. American Can Lofts takes a modern approach on sustainable urban living.
The program would not have been successful without all our partners, including local governments, developers, property owners, certified professionals, certified labs, and our staff at Ohio EPA, working together to revitalize and redevelop properties across the state. Thank you. And we at Ohio EPA can't wait to see what the next 25 years holds. To learn more about the Voluntary Action Program, visit us at epa.ohio.gov.